So the with me and she suck your mum. Not top two, top one. Man must have thought I was dumb. What the fuck have you lot done?
All my things.
Shelling. I made juice, life gave me lemon. You little fuckboys do my head in. Henry the Eighth, behead him. Can't tell where I'm heading. Could be Glasgow, could be Reading. I was in the pool like bedding. Dead him. Big Mac, I'm handling my weight. Big Mac, I'm standing with the grace. One week is blinded by your grace. Next week is bang you in your face. Oh God, they love to wind me up. But one by one, I line them up. What you think you're... Alright, check this, man. Can't talk about stretching fibers. I was on my pushback, ducks and drives. Man, on a distant text in private. Don't wanna pull with the rest of life. I'm not scared of lying bears. The feds can't find us. Think man scared of sex and spiders. Think man scared of sex and cybers. What? Who talking about I'm skilled? Who talking about I'm real? Who talking about I'm true? Big Mac bought a house in the hill. No, a nigga ain't this and a nigga ain't that and a nigga ain't out of the field. Say I'm on this and they say I'm on that. We talking about our bill. To the ground up, put your arms down, put your crown up. Come a long way from playing pound up. Ever motivated, all pound up. They call across for the equal. That's why they're giving me dirty looks. I don't do it for the grand. Do it for the fam. Do it for the back in books. We're still taking up space. I told my niggas rise up. Yes, we're just a bunch of young kids. I made my city light up. I told my city right up. Yeah, Big Mac, who's back in time's up? Yeah, Big Mac, who's back in time's up? Yeah, Big Mac, who's back in time's up? Yeah, Big Mac, who's back in time's up?
All right, guys, how you doing? It's Rabir. Hope you're all good. So I've just got back from probably one of the most intense weekend experiences of my entire life as a guitar player, and that was to headline Reading and Leeds Festival with Stormzy, which I never thought I'd say, but it was amazing and I had a great time. And this video is based on just the details about how the gig came about, the gear I used, you know, my approach to it and everything like that, because I got a load of requests from you guys asking to make a video on this, so I thought I'd give it a go. Firstly, I'll apologize if I look a bit tired. It's been a pretty mental week and a half, and I'm mentally tired as well. But anyway, just wanted to let you guys know I look a bit run down. So at the end of July, I got a call from Jack Duxbury, who some of you guys will know from the Andertons channel, as well as being a really prolific session pianist as well. He'd done stuff with James Bay, and he's a really lovely guy. I've known him for quite a long time, but he gave me a call and he was like, just to give you a heads up, you're going to get a big gig offer. A friend of mine, Kojo, he's an MD, absolutely wonderful guy, amazing MD. He's probably going to get in touch with you because he's just asked me for your details and I thought I'd give him them. So anyway, just a heads up. So I was like, okay, all right then. Then I got a call from Kojo Samuel, who is an amazing MD. He's been an MD for over 10 years or more. He's worked with some incredible artists. Stormzy, of course, Dave, I think Jess Glynn. He's worked with Jesse J, bunch of huge artists. And he gave me a call, super nice dude. And he basically explained the gig, which was basically we're playing Reading and Leeds Festival. And because it used to be more rock orientated, we wanted to sort of tip the hat, you know, for the intro of the show towards that kind of thing. So we wanted to do a big, gritty, heavy rock intro. And we thought that you would be a great addition to the show. So yeah, do you want to do it? And I was like, wow. Yeah, I definitely would be up for that. Obviously, I'm thinking in my head, this is probably the biggest session gig and one of the first session gigs I've ever been offered because, you know, doing what I've done over the last decade on YouTube and working with bands and my own bands and stuff, I haven't really gone into the world of session playing. So that was, you know, one thing I was thinking. But anyway, I said, yes, absolutely. I'd love to do that. And I asked, just out of curiosity, how did you come to ask me to do this gig? And it turns out there's a guy called Bronski, who is one of the sort of show directors. It's his vision for the show, Reading and Leeds, to get, you know, this sort of heavy rock influence, because he used to listen to those kind of bands back in the day, new metal bands. Like myself, the idea of rap and rock slash metal kind of stuff goes really well together. If you're a fan of new metal, you will like that kind of stuff, and he's into that. So anyway, that was the kind of vision. And apparently he just found me on Instagram. I was like, but, I do stuff on YouTube, I do stuff online, like that's kind of where I've based my sort of career around. And they had no idea about any of that. I mean, obviously they'd seen on Instagram, but nothing to do with YouTube and demoing and all this stuff. So I was completely gobsmacked by that they just stumbled across my Instagram page and decided that was the one. Bronski saw it and sent it to Stormzy, who then said, this is the guy, we want to use this guy. So just that alone was mind-blowing, to be fair. But anyway, so I had a great call with Kojo, and that was the beginning of it. That's how I got the gig, basically. So the next thing that I thought to myself was, how am I going to prep for this? I got the track. I, to be fair, don't really listen to Stormzy or UK rap, not because I don't like it, it's just the kind of rap I used to listen to and still do a little bit is like, you know, Dr. Dre from 2001, The Chronic and stuff, Snoop, like Eminem, all that kind of stuff, like Tribe Called Quest, De La Soul, old school hip hop as well. So it's not that I don't listen to rap as such, it's just that I didn't really listen to a lot of UK rap. I think one of the only ones I really listened to was Plan B's first album. But anyway, so I thought, well, I'm going to get stuck into this. So I got the albums, Stormzy's albums, had a listen to them. My sister is a huge fan, so she gave me a lot of good reference points there. And it's, you know, I've been listening to it for a bit and it's cool. It's definitely a different direction of rap that I would listen to, but now, after having done this, I'm definitely into it. I think it's got its place and it's hugely popular. And he's really good at it as well, to be fair. He's got a great sort of flow and a really cool style with it as well. So, you know, anyway, so how I came about doing the intro track was Kojo sent me the sort of rough idea of how the song intro would be with Big Michael bolted onto it kind of thing. So it had like a little intro in front and then it was the main song. And I thought the best way for me to contextualize what I would do with this is to write some riffs over it, program some drums over it, add some bass and everything. And so that's what I did. I created a demo, which this is what it sounds like. With that demo, I sent it to Kojo and said, this is the kind of thing, am I on the right tracks? And he was loving it. So that was the foundation for the intro. When I sent that, then we started collaborating from there on, which was really cool to be involved on that level musically to get to do this. So after that, it was a case of turning up to a couple of pre-production rehearsals. So in terms of what I did to prepare for that, I had to choose my gear, of course. So in terms of gear that I thought I'd use for this gig, of course, I was going to use my signature Chapman, which is this one right here. This is the second prototype, Carthus Burst. We added a push-push to it because I wanted to split down the neck for Blinded by Your Grace. That's going to become a rolling change, actually, so that's cool. But yeah, there's a couple of things I wanted to shout out, actually, in terms of bits of gear that, you know, unexpectedly are really, really useful. The first one being the headstock tuner from Didario. And genuinely, this was so useful on stage because the tech tunes your guitar for you, hands it over to you, do this big intro where I'm really hammering the guitar. And then I've got to stand still like and wait for my next section, which is clean. And it's obviously going to be obvious if I'm out of tune. So I was thinking, what can I do? Because I can't go off stage and tune. I've got no visual aid there. So the headstock tuner was the best because I can roll my volume down because there's not tons of intense sound on stage. It doesn't get tripped out from all the vibrations. So I've got it there. And whilst, you know, Stormzy's doing his bit before I come back in, I can just stand there and tune in peace on stage in darkness so no one can see me, getting it just right. That's awesome. And also, whilst I'm waiting to come on stage for Blinded by Your Grace, even when I'm stood there waiting, I've got it here and I can just stand and just look at my guitar and then be, you know, subtle about it, but be tuning my guitar, making sure I'm all good. That was really useful, like really useful. So a little bit of advice now from having done a gig that intense, always have a headstock tuner on. because it's just going to save your life in case for some reason you can't tune anywhere else. So that was the guitar that I used, of course, and I had a spare, another one, my Smoke prototype actually was going to come out. And then the gear that I chose to rely on the most was the Quad Cortex. Because, I mean, it's so small and portable, and it really, really helped me in the sense of, because I captured all my amps, the sound that you hear in the video is a capture of my Kraken and the Mezzobarba blended together in like a stereo sound. And then I used a Vox AC30 and a Fender Twin stereo clean sound. And yeah, it's really cool to be able to do that and then have it all on scenes that were changing with MIDI. It was just nice and portable and easy for me to get around. And obviously it's the sound of my amps, or as close to as I could get, so I figured that was the best thing to do because I wasn't able to use valve heads and cabs because there was no space, nowhere to put them within the set, the stage set, I mean. So this was really handy. Just there was, I had two, I'll show you a photo now, there was two of them sat on the table, both linked up with a MIDI splitter, changing at exactly the same time, one as a redundancy unit, but yeah, to be honest, it did, it handled it with ease and it sounded great in my ears. It sounded great out front. So hats off to Neural for that, you know. I know you might see that as a bit of a plug, but genuinely, I wouldn't have used it on a gig that intense if I didn't think it was going to deliver, and it absolutely delivered. So let me know what you think of the tones in the comment section. But also, if you own one of these and you've got the app, the preset that I used is now available because I used, you know, you can use the Neural DSP app. I've just made it public. So if you want to check it out and play through the exact same sounds I used at the gig, you can do that now if you go to my profile on the Neural DSP app. I also think it's worth shouting out the other gear dudes that I work with for this gig, of course, Daddario Strings, Bare Knuckle Pickups for their awesome sounding pickups, the Silo pickup in there, Seymour Duncan for the beautiful neck tones, and yeah, Empire Ears for my in-ears. They really are great. Really, really good full quality of sound there. But yeah, I just thought I'd give them a shout out. So then next it was about going to pre-production with this demo in mind, and I'd also been told that I was going to be playing on a song called Blinded by Your Grace, which is like a sort of a worship sort of tune, which has got really nice improv kind of major pentatonic vibes all over it. It's really nice. So I was down with that. More, you know, I could just grab onto that and just play in a similar style. Anyway, turned up to the pre-production rehearsals with this demo in mind, and we started working on it, adding bits, taking bits out, and basically getting a vibe for it, doing the big guitar intro thing as well, which I didn't really think about originally to do some lead at the start, but that's what they wanted, so we added that. And yeah, basically, I had 2 days with them to run through my parts, which were basically the intro song, Big Michael, and Blinded by Your Grace. So we did those, and then it was a few weeks away. After that, just kind of, I'd be brushing up on it regularly just to keep myself in check, getting hold of the rehearsal recordings to listen to and cross-reference my, you know, what I'd done there with what, how I was feeling about the track now, and like adding stuff and changing things. And then we had the full pre-production rehearsals leading up to the festival, which were 3 days back to back in this big, massive studio called Fly By Night in Redditch. And it's this big, big room. And then the stage is set up in there, and basically they run it like they would at the festival. So I also got given a stylist, so I had to wear specific clothes as well, which I got to keep, which is cool, and some new shoes. But yeah, basically the idea was to run it like the show. So at this point, the Quad Cortex was being run on timecode with MIDI off stage, and I'm on wireless. So that was definitely a new experience to be like, this has to change on its own at the right point in the song, and if it doesn't, I'm just going to be with full distortion in a really chilled part. It would be really scary. So there was a few anxieties around that, but we got it working with a guy called Max, who's awesome, and he got it working, so that was cool. I was on wireless, and then basically it was a case of just running those bits, and last minute Kojo was like, I want to add something to the end of Vossy Bop, which is the very last tune of the set. I want to bring it back in with some more like riff and do some lead to play it out, which is basically, we worked on that as soon as we got there. And then it was just a case of running the set like a load of times with the whole band and Stormzy and everybody. And that's what I want to shout out now is the band were absolutely amazing. All the dudes in the band were incredible, and all the vocalists and backing singers were amazing. It was so nice to be in the presence of such awesome musician, world-class musicians and singers that just made it sound beautiful every time when you've got your in-ears mixing and you're just listening every time between your songs, and it just, It was just an amazing experience. So to all the musicians that played, thank you for blessing me with such wonderful music to listen to. But anyway, so we did the pre-production and then it was a day off and then it was the shows. So this is the bit that I suppose I wasn't expecting quite as much, but it came along in waves. And that was that day in between the pre-production and the first festival show was just a day of stressing out and feeling really anxious. I think mainly because it's the first gig that I'd played in over 18 months after all this stuff had changed, after everything that had happened this last couple of years. So I was slightly anxious about that because it's been so long since I've done anything like that. Also, it's been a long time since I've had to do a gig where I'm shredding and doing the lead thing. Usually I'm playing riffs on stage, you know, so that was something that I was thinking, you know, got to be on top of your game. On top of the things like the gear changing on its own with time code, which was scary, thinking what if it doesn't change, all that kind of stuff. On top of the pyrotechnics that I had to be in very specific parts of the stage to make sure that I didn't catch fire. On top of things like, I don't know, just stupid things that you start to worry about. And I had just had this day of anxiety and I was feeling really stressed, gave myself a headache thinking about it too much. And then on the day, on Friday, last Friday, when we got on the bus and led up to the show, I started to chill out a bit, but I was still quite nervous. And then when it came to about the hour before playing, I was stood on stage in the wings with my guitar just warming up. And I saw the crowd and I was like, you know what? It isn't the crowd, it's all this other stuff that's starting to make me feel nervous, all these little things that are out of my control. So I just had to clear my head from that side of things. And luckily, having done things like Nova Rock with Frog Leap, I'd been used to playing in front of such big crowds. I mean, this crowd was 90,000, so it's a lot of people. But something that a lot of people could probably agree with is the more people, the less intense. It's weird. You know, leading up to it, we've got like 10 minutes to go, and I'm just sat in the wings, just playing, just breathing, doing breathing exercises, just keeping myself cool, because I'm thinking, as soon as I play that first note, I know exactly what's going to happen. It's going to feel great. You're going to remember everything, but you just need to get to that point. And once they press play on the playback and it's time to walk out and do it, there's no turning back. It's like Ben described it really well. He said it's like you take that leap into the unknown. It's just like you are going now. So it leads up, you've got all the, in your in-ears, you've got all these cues happening and, you know, the whole thing's to click as well. And you've got cues, audio clicks, like a four count before your sections come in, which is nice. So there's a lot of guide going on as well on playback. But that like last 30 seconds before the lights go down, I was stood there just thinking, this is going to be so epic. This is going to be so intense. Just absolutely just give it everything you've got. You're playing fat riffs, you'll be fine. Just go out there and absolutely smash it. Do it the best you can. Don't get too excited so that you can't play, but get excited enough so it looks good or whatever. And then the intro started. As you've seen at the beginning of the video, I walk out. And as soon as I hit that first note, mix sounded good. Mix was clear. I looked out at the audience. I was like, oh yeah. Hello, my old friend. I remember you. This is epic. We're going to have a good time. And from then on, it was sick. It was just the best. When I walked into the middle of stage and went down for the fire coming up, it was just incredible, to be honest. So I keep watching it back going, that's just mental that I did that. And some of the photos as well. A guy called Timsey did an amazing photo of me with the flames. That I'm gonna get that printed, to be fair. I'm very proud that happened. But anyway, that, you know, is basically how the gig went. In terms of the gig itself, I had a great in-ear mix. I'm only on for such short amounts of time, which is kind of nice coming. And I mean, the intro is a lot of pressure, but after that, like Blinded by Your Grace is such a jam and you're just chilling there and you're part of the stage, just playing, having a good time. Like I keep saying, the mix sounded great. I use Empire ears. They're really good quality in-ears and they sounded fantastic. And I just had wonderful sound. I'm just jamming away. And what's nice is that all the musicians are so good. They add a little flair here and there on the live versions. We all do. We're just adding things differently compared to what we did in rehearsal. And there's a specific bit in Blinded by Your Grace where I think it's Naomi, one of the backing singers, she just went up for the note and you can see me like, you know, I was listening and she did it and I was like, that's sick. And I was even more into the performance after that, which I really enjoyed playing with musicians. That high level of pressure at a gig, but you're all still enjoying playing music and being musical. Like that was a highlight. And yeah, basically throughout that whole period playing, it's just, you're having a great time, just enjoying it. And somehow all the anxiety just lifted immediately after that first note. And then I was having the best time ever. Such a great experience. And of course, at the end as well, with Vossy Bop getting to riff out a bit more. And then also getting a shout out from Stormzy, which is really cool, to finish the night. We did that Friday, we did that Saturday at Leeds. And after that, my sister got to come and watch the Leeds gig and meet Stormzy, and we got to hang out afterwards. And it was just an incredible experience. My sister had the best time. Her and her boyfriend are huge Stormzy fans. So that's basically the experience. It was insane. So that is about as much detail as I can remember at this point, because it was all so intense over that period. But I'm pretty sure I got it all in there. So what I'll leave you with now is a version of Blinded by Your Grace that we did at Reading. And then also at the very end is a little bit of Vossy Bop just to go with that. So that's what happened this last weekend at the end of August 2021. My first gig back was insane, and I had the best time. And I just want to say a huge thank you to Bronski and Stormzy for choosing me, you know, from Instagram to do this gig. And of course, a huge thank you to Kojo for being amazing to work with, all the band, all the singers, the production team. Joel Stanley is a legend. Everybody that was involved in making it so epic, thank you so much for such an awesome experience. Thank you for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed it. I'll see you guys soon.
Alright, listen, if you know this one, just sing it with me, please, man. I'm blinded by your grace. I'm blinded by your grace. By your grace. I'm blinded by your grace. Sing along.
prove. I got holes in my lapel, rubbing shoulders with your girl. Which little said that I will go to jail? Well, I guess you have to hold the L. This is London City, we the worst in the world. Whoa. I tell you, getting freaky in the sheets and taking. Then I'm pretty sugar face with just this. My brothers don't die, we just. Getting freaky in the sheets and taking. Then I'm pretty sugar face with just the top of our head. Reddit Festival. I made some noise for my family, my friends, the War Boys, DJ Tiny, Russ, T.O. Wade, Dave, Rabio, and the Electric.